Orange was able to tailor this pick exactly for it. It was the one that Zico also did predict. And now as the gates open, the question on all of our minds is whether or not this rematch is going to be a repeat if we're going to see Easy Money create a major upset and send Method Orange out of this tournament early.
I think it's important to take into account when we have newcomers such as Easy Money, live broadcast is a lot different than playing in the offline stages or even just playing on the ladder with a live audience monitoring every move you make. That could definitely add a lot of pressure. So I'm curious to see how Easy Money do in that pressure cooker, currently securing crowd control into two members, setting themselves up pretty effectively to bake some giant greater power blasts. They swap to Cedu, looking to close it out early on. Mez protects him. Will this anti-magic shield be enough, or anti-magic zone be enough? It looks to be. The all-in from Easy Money has been thwarted. Nice win share by Cedu, making sure he doesn't go down to that. They did get the glider safeguard at least. Potentially we see a swap to Cedu again. I like that Easy Money are not afraid to go for these risky healer swaps. Definitely trying to keep Cedu on his toes.
Yeah, Varen caught into the room. Greater Power Blast secured onto Trill. Burt trying to get some counter pressure for his team. Methorn's looking to get really aggressive, though. Trill commits the Touch of Death now onto Varen. He responds with the Temporal Shield to deny some of this damage, and it looks like he will be able to survive. I like the Windwalker Death Knight. I think it provides a lot more single-target damage than the Demon Hunter, which is what they need to really pressure down one of these mages. But Burt's been doing a good job building up pressure for his team. Cedu forced to Trinket out, now with no Astral Shift, no Trinket. No anti-magic zone. Cedu is a very vulnerable target to incoming burst damage from Easy Money if they can get a nice clean setup.
Yeah, they've set themselves up for victory, actually. If they can get Cedu in a full polymorph, set up a double-casted greater pyroblast, some feral affinity damage sprinkled on top, I think that they've got a recipe for success here. Cedu needs to be playing in the safest position possible. If he overextends, it could be it. Burn blinks in to set up for the win. He's got the polymorph on Cedu.
Uh-oh.
Varen gets a double ring of frost. Perfect setup. Burt gets the pyro. Varen double blinks in, but where was the stun? Tuna wasn't there with the stun. They missed the most important ingredient, a stun.
Yeah, definitely going to be a little bit of a blunder there for Easy Money. That was such a beautiful setup, but Cedu could still be in a little bit of trouble. Looking to line of sight, Astral Shift gets traded out, and now in Ghost Wolf, he manages to escape behind the pillar. Mez and Trill are going to make it difficult for Burt and Varen to really reconnect to their target. Mez gets polymorphed up. Varen and Burt once again looking for some damage. Who are these greater power blasts going to be cooking up on? It looks like Trill is the target of choice. So he gets chunked down a little bit, getting low. Varen, though, getting soloed in the meantime by Trill. Good counter pressure here from Method Orange. Cedu is just playing so far away. He realizes that he is the main target as he's looking to cross the map once again. Burt looking for a greater power blast. What is he going to do? That last setup we saw onto Cedu, where we were saying they really needed that stun, that was exactly what you want to do. You Dragon's Breath up Cedu, put him in a sheep, double Dragon's Breath on Trill and Mez, into the double Ring of Frost, and that way all three members are controlled. No one can shut down those greater power blasts. That's their opportunity, but another huge setup onto Cedu. Anti-magic zone looking to deny. Cedu has to stay alive. Gladiator safeguard. Is he just going to die through anti-magic zone? Cedu's getting low, caught into the Dragon's Breath. Spiritling Totem traded out. Varen. Big damage from Easy Money, but Varen in the meantime forced into his ice block. And in that last exchange, Method Orange basically traded out everything to survive.
I mean, that was an all or nothing exchange between both teams. Now playing on the ropes really here. It's gonna be danger time for the next couple of setups. Burt looks to set up more greater pyros. Tuna gets a restyle stun, double pyro! Big pies, big kill! Cedu gets blown out in game number one.
Oh my god. Something that you want. I remember even, you know, you go back to LAN with Method Orange in the past too. It's like that first matchup can really just set up everything. They go against a composition that they weren't ready for in jungle cleave, and all of a sudden they find themselves in just a terrible place for that entire tournament. And all of a sudden now, you really do need to be thinking about seeding.
Yeah, and Ben is actually right here. They have gone for the triple orc play here on the side of Method Orange. So Cedar's going to be in stance a little bit shorter.
Yeah, and I think it's a good choice if they are going after Cedu. We'll have to see what exactly Easy Money does. As you kind of alluded to, Zico, all three members are vulnerable. Greater Power Blast is one of the most powerful spells in the game. It does percentage-based damage, so it does the same amount of damage to everyone. Doesn't matter how much stamina or health they have. Big setup here onto Cedu. Both combustions are committed, and Mez gets a really good value out of his anti-magic zone. C2 easily survives.
Yeah, good trade by Mez. Immediate reaction on his part. Now Burt being counter-pressured as Tuna tries to respond. Greater Power is being casted. Varen looks like he's likely to get his off, looking for a second, not opting for it just yet. Trill gets bursted. He predicted the damage. Has that fortified elixir already rolling to reduce the damage. C2 gets caught into a polymorph. Could be trouble. Burt sets up with multiple polymorphs. Who are they going to go after? Do they have denial on this? Burt blinks out of range. They're going after C2. Huge hit incoming. Tons of damage. Ducks around the corner. Manages to survive. Dragon's Breath at low health. Ring of Frost. Not able to land it. C2 able to escape for now.
Yeah, this is one of the problems with the Resto Shaman. C2's just constantly low in this matchup. He's got no trinket. He's super vulnerable. We'll have to see what exactly can happen. Ooh. Burt looking for a Ring of Frost. C2 barely dodging it. Now Burt blinking in. Looking for a polymorph on Trill. Greater Pyroblast going to be channeled out. Who is it going to be on? And one of the sneaky things we see Fire Mages do is they actually have macros for Focus Greater Pyroblast. So it's difficult for Method Orange to tell who exactly they're going to be baking these pies on. Is it a focus cast? Is it a targeted cast? That's why all three members of Method Orange really have to be paying attention.
Good denial on that setup. That could have been the end of the game with no Glyre's Medallion unseated. But now that Method Orange have thwarted that assault, it's time to attack. Burt in trouble. Tuna with no Iron Bark. It's a race against the Temporal Shield. Who is going to break first? As Burt gets bursted, Temporal goes off, starts to recover. Method Orange looks like Trill wants to just push out, but there's multiple Greater Pyroblasts incoming. Baron free casting. See what they can do to disrupt this. Burt setting up with a double Frost Nova, maybe for Tuna to sneak away and regenerate some mana. Mez is trying to snipe that out and prevent it from happening. Baron blinks in, gets the Dragon's Breath Polymorph. This is where we see a double Ring of Frost on the DPS, but it whiffs. Burt isn't able to secure the crowd control. I love this Earth Elemental on Tuna, keeping him in combat and preventing him from using Prowl to get re-stealth stuns in that Feral Affinity. Good presence of mind from Cedu to send that Elemental after him, removing that stun potential.
Trill had really good backup on CD, though. He had his Transcendence on that box, so he was able to port back and slow down one of the Greater Pyroblasts, denying Varen. Now Burt in a little bit of trouble. Dragon's Breath is going to be used by Varen to try to assist Burt and survive. Greater Pyroblast now looking to be cast out, but Trill interrupts. One lands onto Trill, but it's not that big of a deal. And Mez, he's using Dark Simulacrum, so one of the spells he can steal is a Greater Pyroblast looking to bake some pies of his own. And if that lands, it's going to be 35% damage to Burt or Varen, definitely contributing to the one-shot capability of Method Orange. If they can find it, Burt in some trouble, a lot of damage. Cauterize Crocs, I think it was off the back of a Pyroblast from Mez. Ring of Frost on Cedu, that falls. Now, once again, Method Orange looking good to be pushing in and getting aggressive.
Mez is trying to steal the secret family recipe and dish out some Greater Pyros of his own. Will he be able to find it and win the game for his team? We are about to find out here shortly. Burt counter-aggressing, Trill on the run, ducking for cover with Cedu at the box. Mez exposed in center field. Varen getting through one interrupt. Burt setting up. Could be a double G-Pi here attempted by Easy Money. Not able to secure it just yet. Polymer from the Fist of Fury. Where's the denial? Mez prevents this Greater Power Blast. Tuna moves in for a stun. Cedu gets caught in a polymorph. Setup looks good. Huge Meteor connects. Trill has to trade. Burt exchanges Temporal Shield. In the meantime, they set up on Cedu in the back line as well. Easy Money trying to go for a two-pronged attack. Cedu struggling to deal with it right now, managing to slowly but surely recover. Ring of Frost locking the team down. Ring of Peace denies the connect. Varen gets a polymorph, unfortunately on diminishing return, but maybe it doesn't matter if it sets up for a Greater Pyro. Varen connects one onto Cedu. Burt can't back him up. Burt's in trouble. I do believe the Cauterize is already proc, so he needs to be extra careful.
Yeah, definitely really scary. As you're right, Cauterize is already proc'd for Burt. One Greater Pyroblast being used by Varen gets grounded by Cedu, so great job by Cedu on that Restoration Shaman. He can use the Grounding Totem to redirect the Pyroblast into the ground, essentially completely nullifying the damage that happens. Now Cedu into a Polymorph, double Dragon's Breath. Do they have the Ring of Frost? Trill and Cedu caught in a Polymorph. What is Mez going to do? Asphyxiate on one mage. Combustion gets used on Cedu. He's in a little bit of trouble. Yes! Oh, Pyroblast going to connect. Ah! It just fall. He's getting more. Spirit Link Totem trades out at 1% health. Cedu barely holds on. That was a 2-for-1 bake sale that Method Orange almost fell to.
Bake sale here. Now into dampening. Scary moment for Method Orange. Easy Money looking to knock the BlizzCon champions out of the competition. The spicy newcomers, can they cook up a victory is now the question. Burt under fire needs to be careful. Trill and Mez leading the charge. Tuna denies. Mez sees Tuna is trying to escape and try and get a drink, but not able to find it. Burt now setting up with multiple Greater Pyros. Gets stopped on the second one. Tuna moves in for a stun. Dragon's Breath on Cedu. Good crowd control initiated by Easy Money here. as they try to set up a swap. Troll needs to make sure that he responds appropriately. He's in a 3-on-1, but he's actually owning Bert. 3 against 1.
Uh-oh.
Bert tries to set up on Cedar with a surprise attack, making it look like he was going after Trill, but all along trying to go after Cedar. Bert gets gripped back downstairs. It caught no stun. Trill now gets swapped too. Cedar has to keep his eyes on every member of his team. Easy money are unpredictable.
Definitely all over the place, and that's one of the great things about these Fire Mages is they can take anyone down with those greater power blasts. So all three members of Method Orange really have to be on their toes, making sure they're interrupting all the greater power blasts. It's not that huge a deal if one gets off, but if both mages are able to bake up some pies, it becomes very scary for your team. Baron once again looking for a greater power blast. Cedu backs him up with the wind shear. Now Trill and Mez looking for pressure, but they're both caught into a Frost Nova. Trill Tiger's Lust. Mez uses the Wraith Walk. Now they're all over Bert. Still with an ice block, though, Bert's going to be feeling relatively healthy. Beautiful temporal shield before the stun. He should be able to hold on. Baron has to back him up. Big pressure here from Method Orange, but Bert manages to hold on from Tuna's Ironbark.
Double ring of frost. Cedu locked in. No, gets gripped on it. Good denial by Mez. Nope, Cedu soon gets caught in the polymorph. Are they going to set up on Cedu? Tuna's moving in. Tuna's ready for this. Baron positions. Gets interrupted by Mez. Bert gets one off. But Tuna can't stun. He gets it late. Is that late stun going to be enough? Cedar trades. He just wants to respect that situation and not go down. But now without his Gladiator's Medallion, he's exposed later on.
Yep, Cedar, no Gladiator's Medallion, no Astral Shift. And guess what? Baron and Bert, double combustion available. Trill getting low. They have to crowd control Mez. Mez needs to make sure he holds onto his anti-magic zone. Trill definitely doesn't want to fall. Fortifying Brew and Diffuse Magic trade out. Trill, 5 seconds left on the Touch of Karma, but still in a little bit of trouble. Cedar trying to top him off so he can get aggressive once again. You don't want to be leaving Mez in midfield. Baron gets a greater power blast. Bert looking for one as well, but Mez shuts both of them down. Nicely done. Tuna potentially looking for a drink here. He is in stealth. He can reset his mana. Things will be looking good for easy money. Method Orange, they have to try to find an opening. Bert getting low. Touch of death. One Gladiator's Maledict. Bert could be in a lot of trouble right now. It looks like he will be able to hold on off the back of that Ring of Peace as Baron. And Bert looking to set up on Cedu. They get the Ring of Frost. Cedu could be in a lot of trouble, but he realizes it. Now Cedu in a polymorph. Bert and Baron try to take down Cedu. If he gets caught into a stun, this could be a great time.
Here comes double greater pyro, multiple meteors flying in. Mez saves the day. It needs to be enough defense to deny the kill. Another perfect combo by Easy Money gets deflected, and Method Orange have a significant mana advantage if they can hang on a little bit longer. And Cedar's just panicking, drops a Spearling Totem. Bird's still under fire, needs to be careful. Temporal Shield seconds away from going off and healing him back into the fight. Manages to stay alive. Fortunately for Easy Money, they got the Spearling Totem. Now in Dampening, Mez becomes a target as well. It's still anyone's game.
Definitely, but Tuna running out of tools and running out of mana. Bert looking for a greater power blast. Baron lands one as well. Mez getting low. He needs to hold on. He needs to get the Death Strike. If he can hold on to it and get the Death Strike off, he will be able to keep himself alive. Heal up quite a bit on that Death Knight. Cedu panicking. He can't spend his mana fast enough. This is the problem with Restoration Charm. He's got full mana, but just doesn't have the heals to keep Mez alive. Trill now getting aggressive on the Bert, getting polymorphed up. Bert looking for a greater power blast. Do they have an interrupt? No, they don't. Bert lands one. Who's it on? Dragon's Rest sets up the team of Easy Money. Cedu getting low, but
double.
Method Orange are going to be able to stabilize.
Oh, multiple Gliders, Maledicts. Bert on the run. The Cauterizes proc ice block forced. The last line of defense for Bert is now out of the way. Both teams are vulnerable. Dampening isn't going anywhere but up. The healing is now significantly reduced at 27%. Who is going to fall first? If Easy Money can close out on a small map, move to match point, it's looking solid for them to just walk away with the rest of the series. Baron setting up with a greater power blast. Cedu denies. Bert under pressure. Can Bert stay alive long enough for one more push? It's going to be off the back of Cedu making a mistake. Cedu has the answers to survive this hit. They should be able to stay aggressive. Gets counterspelled. Maybe an opportunity to attack. Bert gets denied on that greater pyro blast. Still down at half health. Cedu in crowd control. Baron needs this polymorph. He's not able to get the polymorph. Cedu grounding totems hit. Now Bert in trouble.
Big trouble. Touch of death committed by Trill. Bert getting low. Needs to use temporal shield. He's getting lower and lower. Could get taken down very easily. I don't think he has cauterize left to work with. No ice block available. Tuna, no mana left. What is Easy Money going to do? Baron setting up for a greater power blast. Who's it on? It doesn't matter. Bert gets taken down. Method Orange, a few close calls in that matchup.
Deliver the blow. Make Cedu die. Voila. The perfect pie. Easy Money looking to make their strategy work. Yet again, will they be able to take down Method Orange 2 times in this tournament?
All right, the newcomers. Easy Money looking like they're cooking with honey here in game number one. It's Tolvaron Arena. It's bright and sunny. Sidhu, are your eyes starting to get runny?
What?
I don't know. I tried to one-up Rich.
I was with you until that last one.
I had to improvise it, man.
I don't know about
Rich wrote that down.
I like that. No, you did good, Sid.
All right. Sidhu in a polymorph. What are Burt and Varen going to be able to get done? Here's the double combustion. Sidhu could be in some trouble. Anti-magic zone, a really good trade for Mez, keeping Sidhu alive, and I like this. Method Orange, I feel like against this composition, sometimes they get in their own head. They need to play it calm, cool, and collected, make out efficient trades. On game number one, we saw Sidhu trade out his Trinket, as well as the Astral Shift and Anti-Magic Zone. It just creates openings for Easy Money. They respond appropriately. I think they can definitely survive these one-shot attempts from Easy Money.
All right, Method Orange get through the Iron Bark, they get through the Temporal Shield. So now this big push could be a cauterized Ice Block if they can stay on target. Let's see if they can. Tuna's in stealth. He's sneaking around the map. He's going to pounce on a Sidhu. Varen, is he in position to get that Greater Pyro? One Greater Pyro in the sky. Burt wasn't able to get a follow-up. I don't think they've got enough damage to really pressure Sidhu too much here as he ducks around the corner. Now Troll and Mez need to start getting aggressive. They're 1 second away from that Temporal Shield. Burt buys the time with the Double Dragon's Breath, setting up for some Greater Pyros, at least getting through some of the interrupts from the team of Method Orange. Now, you guys obviously have a lot more experience playing this composition than probably anyone in the game. How do you feel about using the combustions at the same time as opposed to splitting them up?
Well, I think the problem for Easy Money when they use the combustion at the same time is obviously Mez is getting really efficient trades with the anti-magic zone. So in this particular case, I think if they can get at least one greater power blast off, potentially, then they could be looking to split up their combustion and they'll have enough damage to take someone down. But that being said, if they do get the anti-magic zone out of the way, then these greater power blast attempts are going to be super effective onto Sidhu as he gets low. Astral Shift trades with Spirit Link Totem as well. Sidhu's really scared in that situation. And that's what I'm talking about. If they use double combustion, get anti-magic zone out of the way, then these next attempts with greater power blast become really scary for Method Orange.
All right, Varen and Burt's picking the big map and setting up big damage here against Method Orange, the reigning BlizzCon champions against the newcomers, the new chefs in the kitchen, trying to cook up some victory. Sidhu able to escape to safety. Good disruption by Mez with that asphyxiate. Varen under fire. Burt trying to cycle up some huge damage while Varen is tanking them effectively. Burt getting multiple greater pyros. Trill in trouble. Touch of Karma redirects some of that greater pyro damage, but now without that Touch of Karma, Trill's gonna have to keep his eyes wide open.
Yep, definitely a little bit scary there for Trill. No Trinket, no Touch of Karma, and he is a potential opening for the team of Easy Money as eating a greater power blast, but he wants to recover behind the pillars. He is able to top off everyone. And now Method Orange in full retreat. And this is the advantage Easy Money has on this map. It's a huge, wide open space, which makes it difficult to shut down both of these fire mages. And now Burt and Varen both have their combustion available as well. So big one-shot potential available. Mez needs to make sure he's going to be able to have his trinket trade out anti-magic zone. Ring of Frost attempt there, but Mez able to shut it down. Polymorph comes in. Tuna looking like he wants to be in position. They get a stun. What are they going to do on Sidhu? There's a greater power blast being channeled out by Burt, but it gets completely shut down.
Did it?
No greater power blast. I think Sidhu should be able to survive off the back of that anti-magic zone. And once again, both combustions committed by Easy Money.
Yeah, Easy Money trying to go for a big blowout there, but Method Orange once again deny. Mana, though, is looking great for Tuna. Unlike on Dalaran Sewers, he's able to easily escape, get into stealth as he is right now. Jumping into the fight, stunning up Trill. Burt setting up some greater pyros, one in the sky. Looking for a second. This could be trouble. Two greater pyros onto Trill. Diffuse magic denies the kill. Overlapped with that Gladiator Safeguard. I do like that Easy Money are attacking multiple targets, really trying to run Sidhu for a loop as far as predicting where their next big push is going to go.
What are they going to do? For Method Orange, it just seems really difficult on this map to really get anything going. Both Burt and Varen both have their ice blocks available. I think Trill, Sidhu, and Mez, they need to hold on to all their defensive cooldowns and eventually make an all-in push with triple Maledict onto either Varen or Burt. And in dampening, they can definitely push through some of those restoration druid defenses. Burt gets gripped in into a leg sweep. Varen looking like he wants to get in position for a potential Dragon's Breath sheep onto Sidhu. He actually sneaks in the sheep. Now Varen cooking up a greater pyroblast. What is Sidhu going to do? Paralysis by Trill. And that's the thing about the Windwalker Death Knight is they have a lot of tools. Sidhu forced to trinket.
Burt
gets a greater pyroblast. Sidhu getting low. Triple Dragon's Breath sets him up. Sidhu caught all alone. Is he going to be able to survive? He churns out his trinket. And he's still so low. The Maledicts. Early able to keep Cedu alive there. Cedu still has a Spiritling Totem. He greeds it huge, able to hold on to it, but that was a really close call, and Method Orange traded out a lot to survive there.
Yep, easy money, showing that they can definitely take it to Method Orange. Mez actually stealing a Polymorph, throwing that on Tuna. Could be an opportunity to force an Ice Block from Vert. They can't stay on target. Double Polymorphing up Mez and Trill at the same time. Cedu doesn't have enough dispels to get both of them out of that chain, denying an Ice Block forced opportunity here from Method Orange. Dampening now kicking in, and it's going to pay favors to both sides as Death Strike becomes weaker, as well as the heal over time effects from the Restoration Druid. In the meantime, Easy Money, they set up a Polymorph. Tuna's trying to get a restealth. They don't stop him right in front of him. Cedu gets stunlocked. That's going to be an anti-magic zone. Once again, Combustion's overlapped at the same time. This is why I was trying to say, like, do you think they should start splitting them up? Because it seems so efficient for Mez.
Yeah, definitely Mez is getting huge value. There's no question about that. It's just a matter of if Easy Money's just trying to bait out that anti-magic zone, but they may be able to just get it with one. Definitely something they could potentially experiment with, and then it's more difficult for Method Orange to really commit that major defensive cooldown. So maybe they need to spice it up a little bit, mix it up.
Bring
a piece. Up in the sky. Unfortunately, misplaced by Trill. I'm not sure if it actually interrupted anything there, but Burt getting bursted down, leg sweep. Big burst potential here for Method Orange. No touch of death, and Burt should be able to survive with the temporal shield, but this is a good situation for Method Orange to be in. They still have a lot of defensives to rotate through. Burt, no temporal shield. Tuna, no iron bark. Do they have the damage? Cedu trades out his earthen shield totem to keep Mez and Trill aggressive, but now caught in midfield. Both Mez and Trill are very vulnerable.
All right, Mez has got his pet sent after Tuna. Tuna needs to find an opportunity to drink and regenerate mana so that they can push this into a deeper dampening play to potentially kill Mez. It will be so difficult for Mez to get back to the pillar if he's out in center field trying to push for ice blocks. Burt in position, gets one greater pyro, looking for a second. Nobody's interrupting them. Two greater pyros, three greater pyros. I guess Cedar's just gonna power heal through it. Big hit with multiple Maledicts. Burt then blinks over and secures Polymorphs. That puts Mez behind and deeper into dampening. They bank an Icebound Fortitude right before the critical mass. This is setting up well for Easy Money to take down Mez.
Yeah, Burt blinks in aggressive though. Mez able to get some damage rolling. And now near the pillar, Method Orange is gonna be feeling relatively safe. Burt getting gripped behind the pillar. He shimmers away using the Gladiator's Medallion to get out of the stun. Now, there's an opening here for Method Orange. Burt has no trinket. If they can get a full leg sweep on him and commit a lot of damage with the Touch of Death, definitely an opportunity for them to get something rolling. There's the Iron Bark committed as well. So now Burt, no trinket, no temporal shield. Tuna, no Iron Bark. Great opportunity for Method Orange and Trill with that Touch of Death to bank the first ice block and potentially the only ice block Burt will have available. Oh. Maledict does come flying in. Burt does not want to mess around. All three Maledicts committed there by Method Orange. Burt trades out the ice block. It's a fair trade. That was a really scary moment for Easy Money.
I want to see Burt just stay in this wizard corner. It's going to be a risky move to push in on him in that position because then Varen will free cast greater pyros and Burt will likely get them off as well. So you've got a choice as Method Orange. When do you make the push? Because you're going to have to fight in enemy territory in that far corner. They're going to need to make sure that they have a Spirit Link Totem or an anti-magic zone to exchange when they make that big push, and they're going to have to make the call perfectly so they have enough damage to overwhelm Burt and still enough defense to stay alive while they push forward into the midfield. Tuna takes advantage of this opportunity to just regenerate mana. It's going to all come down to one final push. Method Orange have multiple answers to exchange. They should be able to take it unless they throw. So let's see if Easy Money can put some pressure on here, force Method Orange to make a mistake.
Yeah, Burt gets gripped in behind the pillar. That's going to be a great opportunity for Method Orange to really start getting that momentum rolling in their favor. So Burt has to play behind Varen in.
There it is.
Gets gripped, asphyxiate. What damage do we see from Method Orange? Varen responds with the Dragon's Breath, looking for a Polymorph. Cedu shuts it down with a beautiful Wind Shear. Triple Dragon's Breath, Ring of Frost.
Double.
Looking for the Ring of Frost. The eight going to be made there by Burt and Varen. Now Mez in a Polymorph. Trill has to shut down these greater pyroblasts.
Cedu!
One being cooked up by Burt. Big damage on Cedu. Anti-magic zone trades.
Split.
Cedu will be able to survive, but like you said, Sid, now Varen with the combustion, they have the double threat, and Mez with no anti-magic zone could be very vulnerable.
All right, Varen's going to have to hard carry here if they want to take down Cedu. Still, Method Orange need to make mistakes, I think. They are far ahead on cooldowns. They could definitely overwhelm Burt. Maybe they just kill him outright with tons of damage. Trill looking to close it out. Just owning Burt. Burt on the run, but his health is ticking away. Is he going to be able to hold out? Tuna's healing is so reduced.
Oh,
not enough.
He stole it.
Stole the rest
of the bakes a pie of his own.
And playing with fire gets easy money. They can win here, or easy money can bring it to a game five.
I mean, Method Orange looks so strong on Tolvaron, which is much worse than Ashermain's Fall. If they're going to do it, I think they are going to do it now. They've definitely figured out Easy Money's composition. I think they're going to need to mix up their strategies a bit more. They've got Cedu out in the open. Varen moves in. Burt gets the Dragon's Tooth. Varen gets one, but Trill's left open. He's going to deny Burt, but Cedu still gets Polymorph. Burt sets up for a double Ring of Frost. Greater Power Blast in the sky gets gripped. Tuna's in position to pounce. Stunning up Cedu. Greater Power Blast connects from Burt. Huge combustion damage. Where is the anti-magic zone? They're holding out on it because they didn't go for the double combustion. Good presence of mind from Mez. Astral Shift exchange much better for that, and now Anti-Magic Zone can trade for Varen's. Method Orange making mid-game adaptations.
Yeah, I really like Cedu going over to the Orc as well. These Rake Stuns from Tuna, not going to be nearly as effective. Varen connects one Greater Power Blast. Trill redirects the damage on the Burt. Looking for a big push here. Trill could be a little bit vulnerable. One Maledict does connect. Second Greater Power Blast coming in. Trill gets stunned up. What is he going to do? Cedu in a good position here to back his team up. But you can see Burt or Varen moving in, gets the Dragon's Breath Sheath onto Cedu. Now Trill being a little bit vulnerable. He uses Transcendence to get away out of line of sight, and he should be completely fine.
Ooh, they tried to set up on Cedu. Burt's Greater Power Blast not finishing in time, and that could be the difference of Flames of Alacrity. Haste, two Power Blasts in the sky there. May have forced a cooldown, but not able to squeak it in time. Both DPS members in Polymorphs. Varen and Burt pull back to set up Pyros. Trill gets stunned up. Burt trying to kill him. Mez grips Burt away. Mind freezes Varen. Good denial on Mez's part here. Burt and Varen now looking at like they want to get aggressive. Varen leads the charge. Gets Ring of Peace on the Polymorph. Cedu then wins
the
blink. This is really good denial from Method Orange. Great coordination.
Yet they're working together like a well-oiled machine. Trill backing up Cedu. Cedu backing up Trill. Trill taking a little bit of burst damage from one Greater Power Blast. Varen gets interrupted on the second. This is what I'm talking about. You allow one to get off, not that big of a deal. You got to save most of your interrupts for the big setups that come in from Easy Money. One Greater Power Blast can be healed through. Multiple in a stun is when it becomes very devastating. So that's what Method Orange has been looking to shut down, and they've been doing a good job. Varen blinks in, looking for a Dragon's Breath. Fortunately, misses it. Cedu doing a good job just running around this pillar, and Ghost Wolf making it really difficult for Easy Money to get the setups that they really want.
This is looking better and better for Method Orange. Varen getting pressured. Tuna moves forward, relying on the Temporal Shield. Now able to recover. Burt and Varen both setting up Greater Power Blast. Burt finishes his cast. Now gets Grounding Totemed by Cedu. Burt goes for another. Manages to get one. Blinks back to make sure he can get the second. Trill now on the run. Ducking out of line of sight. Giving Cedu time to recover. Then immediately charging back into the battle. Huge hit on Varen. That must have... wasn't it even a stolen Greater Power... Varen's in so much trouble. If they manage to get any crowd control on Tuna, I love this Earth Elemental usage from Cedu throughout this entire day. That Earth Elemental that's punching Tuna the Druid, it's stopping him from using Prowl and getting into stealth and accessing stuns. And that Earth Elemental stays up for an extended period of time, so it removes any kill window opportunity. And that's like a very small thing, but it's definitely effective, and Cedu taking full advantage of it. Burt getting bursted down, but Varen in position to free cast, gets gripped in. Multiple Pyros, Trill gets stunned. He preemptively Touch of Karma that incoming bash. Now he should be all right to survive. Maybe not. They're just going all in for a kill on Trill. He uses the Diffuse Magic, but there's multiple Maledicts. Tuna's moving in. If he can get a Cyclone. They're actually setting up on Cedu. Huge swap. Cedu trinkets. He trades. He stays alive, but how much longer? He's very low on health in midfield. Not where you want to be facing down two Fire Mages.
Yep, but Burt and Varen, their damage will run out, and Cedu doesn't panic in that situation. And this is what I'm talking about. Method Orange are getting a lot more comfortable with the incoming Fire Mage damage. Varen getting low. Ring of Peace used by Trill to deny Burt. But defensively, Method Orange, they're looking solid. They're not overlapping. Cedu holds onto the Spirit Link Totem. Mez, although that was scary for his team, holds onto the Anti-Magic Zone. And I really am impressed with the gameplay from Method Orange in this particular matchup. They really stepped up compared to game number one and the previous series in this tournament.
Tuna trying to sit down for a drink and regenerate mana while Method Orange are playing defensive at the pillar. They don't want to overextend Trill right now as he doesn't have many defensive cooldowns to save himself to a double Greater Power. So they send Mez to try and bait some damage, then immediately retreats back, denied the drink again. See if Tuna can manage to regenerate mana or not. Mez's Ghoul running across the battle to try and deny Tuna's re-stealth.
Yeah, Tuna was a fish out of water there as Bert summoned a refreshment table for him in order to regenerate some mana.
That's what you were so...
Yes. I mean, that was pretty good, right?
That was
literally the best one ever, Sid.
Yeah. All right. Sid is just never happy with my puns, you know? I try to step up and...
I just want the best from you, okay?
That was not bad. Come on, man. Double Lexi now 100.
Literally the best one ever.
Double Lexi on Bert and Varen. Big burst damage here from Method Orange. Triple Dragon's Breath denies. Tuna still has his Iron Bark, so Method Orange is going to have to work through that if they want to actually land a kill.
Fish out of water. Oh, that's incredible.
Tuna moves in but doesn't stun. They whiff the stun. They stun Seedu out of the... This is very uncoordinated from Easy Money, and they're looking like more of an Easy Bake Oven.
An Easy Bake
Oven. That one was terrible. The fish out of water was fantastic. You have no taste.
All right.
I'm not going to chime in here.
What is Varen going to do? Bert lands one greater pyroblast. Good damage here onto Mez, but he gets recovered quite easily, and that's one of the things pre-dampening, or at this early stages of dampening, a Death Knight can heal himself up through a greater power blast. One lands, you use Deathstrike, you get healed up for the majority of that damage, and you're going to be completely fine. So in order to take Mez down, you have to get overwhelming amounts of damage.
All right, Seedu caught in crowd control, but they don't get any setup off the double Ring of Frost. That's usually devastation for the double Fire Mage, but they don't manage to tee off. Tuna sitting down for a drink, and I believe he's going to regenerate back to full mana, which is very important right here as dampening kicks in. Both teams are evening out. Dark Simulacrum, what is Mez trying to steal? We're going to have to wait and see if he managed to get anything potent there. They're going for a Maledict play onto Bert. They dispel that off quite easily. A little bit of an uncoordinated assault from Method Orange in terms of aggression. Maybe it doesn't matter. They could just overwhelm Bert. They're really looking to try and get Cauterizer blocked before we hit critical mass and dampening. Seedu overextending to keep his team going. Now Bert and Varen trying to set up on him. Varen gets Ring of Peace on his greater power blast. Bert is being pressured away on his. Varen's trying to sneak across the map to get Seedu in crowd control. Seedu sees him coming, isn't able to duck around the corner fast enough. Dragon's Breath into Ring of Frost. This could be devastating. Varen sets up one greater power blast. Trill moves over to try and stall. He's now in a polymorph. Bash on Seedu. It looks clean. Two pies in the sky. Anti-magic zone. Is that going to be enough?
Yep.
Looks like it's going to be, but they overlap with the astral shift. Fortunately, that was an all-in from Easy Money, so trading your all-out defensive lineup is more than enough, and now Method Orange get aggressive.
Yeah, and Seedu still has his Trinket and Spear Link. That line of defense should keep Method Orange nice and healthy. Bert and Varen trading out quite a bit there. That was a beautiful setup, but with Mez trading out his anti-magic zone, he got huge value, a lot of damage reduction. Varen looking for a Power Blast, manages to find one. No, it gets grounded by Seedu. Varen now casting his third greater Power Blast in a row. Who are they on? One lands on Mez, Deathstrike lands. He gets topped off. Seedu in the back line, throwing out some heals as well. They're just teeing off on Mez. They've kind of abandoned Trill. Trill's been doing a really good job rotating through his Diffuse Magic, his Touch of Karma, his Fortifying Brew, his Transcendence. Has a lot of defensive tools available, but his dampening gets higher and higher. I think Mez is going to be an increasingly vulnerable target.
Yep, Seedu hunting down Tuna to deny him from re-stealthing. It's going to be really important to stall that out as much as possible. Bert trying to get a greater power, gets interrupted. Varen free casting in midfield. Nope, gets sheared by Seedu. Good denial once again from Method Orange. Their play is looking clean here against Easy Money. Let's see if they can sneak in any power plays. They've got Seedu in a polymorph. Bert tries to set up and support Varen. They're not able to find it. Paralysis, they go for another polymorph. They're still trying to squeak through here. Greater Power Blast, they need to get this one. Seedu actually uses the Glider's Medallion very prematurely on that attack. He will survive for now, but opens himself up later on. Spearling Totem gets traded out. Bert in under fire with that Cauterize now triggered. Both teams running low on cooldowns. Dampening continues to rise.
Yeah, Seedu traded out Trinket, Ascendance, and Spirit Link now into a polymorph. What is Bert gonna do? Connecting his damage. Trill doesn't mess around. He turns at the Touch of Karma. Bert very vulnerable here with no Cauterize. He still has the Ice Block, but it'd be scary. He needs to make sure he gets that off in time. Trust me, I know. Method Orange looking for some damage still, but Polymorph Spam is going to deny a lot of that. Bert getting all in here. Maledix, as he gets low, trades out the Ice Block, will survive, but now Easy Money, they're running out of time, and they're running out of defensive cooldowns.
All right, what are they going to do? Are they going to push in? Varen misses the Dragon's Breath. Seedu was able to dodge it. Now they're not going to be able to set up crowd control. This is dire for Easy Money. Tuna sneaks across the battlefield. He's trying to set up the team. Ringer Frost hits one member. They need to get Trill in that, but they're not falling for it. They just go for an instant cast burst window. Mez denies the kill with the anti-magic zone. Maybe it's not enough at 28% dampening. We'll find out shortly. Burt under fire. Tuna Trinkets out to respond. Cedu manages to escape. Burt and Varen in desperation just trying to stall out the game and maybe stay on target. A stolen polymorph might close out the game. Mez once again MVP. Burt in trouble. Temporal shield seconds away from going off. Not gonna do it. Mez closes out on match.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.